Any selling activity can be divided into various stages and in various sequences and models. By not commenting on any such model or models, and by not going into the criticism of these models, we shall propose a chronological order of the various stages during any sale.
His day begins half an hour later than that of his boss. In great style. Mukul is a confident salesperson, one who feels that pre-planning of the call sequence is a waste of time. That he forgets about his appointment is normal. Let's see where he lands up.
Yes, come in. Yes. Push on.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
I am Mukul from Coolindel Limited. How do you do?
What cool did you say?
My name is Mukul, sir. I am from Cool India.
Can I have your card?
My card?
Yes, sir.
This card has all the details, sir. Where did I? Just a moment, sir. It's there, sir. It is there. I just saw it this morning. I've run out of earlier stock, I think. Yeah, there it is. I've got. It's a little dirty card, sir, but I think it'll do. So we are a refrigeration company, sir, and we make air conditioners for offices and houses and other things. And the best advantage we give, sir, that our prices are very low as compared to the other products in the market, you know. Whereas they are priced at 20,000 rupees, ours is 18,000. So it is much better to go for our product than to buy anything else from the market. Would you be interested in buying one? It is very hot here.
Well, why don't you go and check out with the purchase manager? I don't deal with all these things.
A purchase manager, sir?
Yeah, that's
right, sir. Can you give me his name, sir? Purchase manager.
Well, please go and check at the reception. I've got to go for an urgent meeting.
Oh. Nice. Thanks a lot, sir. Any phone number, sir?
Please.
Okay, all right. Thanks a lot.
This was a nightmare of a call. But then, given another opportunity, Mukul transforms into a real performer.
The performer has to practice a lot and sharpen his or her skills to avoid chaos during a call. A salesperson gathers complete details on the client and his specific requirements.
Hello. Can I meet with Hari Enterprise, please? Yes, Mr. Hariya, he is the managing director. Hello, is that Hari Enterprise? Yes, I am Mukul Varma from Cool India Limited. And I wanted to find out if Mr. Haryal is in. Yes. Well, if he's busy today, can you fix up an appointment for tomorrow, 10 o'clock? 10:30. Well, that suits me. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much.
Hey, Mukul, don't forget to carry your common sense and confidence.
The significance of gaining the attention of the beholder is the obvious first step in...
Cool selling. From Cool India Limited. What did you say your name was? I am Mukul Verma from the Cool India Limited, sir. We market and manufacture air conditioners, and I've come to know you've got a very specific need for air conditioners, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Well, by the way, who told you about us?
Sir, everyone knows about it now. And of course, the article in Business India last month, I did that.
Building up of interest comes next, after having gained attention. Before you give your client an optimum exposure of your product knowledge, identify his needs for him and then propose your product or services to fulfill them. The test of common sense is the ability to hold two opposite ideas in mind at the same time and still retain the ability to function as per plan with modest alterations.
Here we have a young lady who is smart enough to push her product for sample testing and then demonstrates the skill to counter objections entirely on the basis of her product knowledge.
I represent Energy India Limited.
Please have a seat.
Thank you. I think you're already familiar with our company.
That's right.
We supply you various pharmaceutical products and we're now diversifying into health drinks. May I ask you what you serve your patients with their meals?
Tonics only.
And what is their response to that?
There is resistance. Tonics are more like medicines, so there is resistance, no doubt.
Yes, well, we've been finding that in most of our surveys, that because they're at a low ebb psychologically, they don't want to be given another tonic or medicine or something like that.
Are you comfortable? It is a little warm today. Would you like to have a soft drink?
Well, I'd love a drink, but not a soft drink. I'll have a happy health drink. Would you like to join me? This is a happy health drink, our new product. Please try it.
I don't mind. It tastes like grape juice.
That's because of the sweetener we've added.
Oh, I don't like this additive nonsense whatsoever.
Yes, well, I understand your skepticism about that, but this sweetener has been approved by Government of India and by other leading medical associations.
I see. What else do you have?
It has 9% cherry juice, 7% apple juice, and 6% pineapple juice.
That makes more of a fruit juice.
It is a fruit juice, but it's also a health drink. We've added vitamin C. In fact, this has 2 parts to every 10 of vitamin C.
But that will jack up your prices very much.
To an extent. But if you compare it to serving your patients fresh fruit juice, this is far more economical.
Well, Miss Singh, you seem to know the product very well.
That's my job.
Some product knowledge, that was. Well, let's see how one lands up in a tight corner for want of adequate knowledge on the product and the client. Come in.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, madam.
Well, are you so surprised to see a woman sitting there?
No, I was expecting Mr. Sachena. He's been transferred, madam.
Well, yes, he has.
I'm from High Health Food.
High Health Food?
No, Health Foods Limited, sir.
Health Foods Limited?
Yes, sir.
What a
gentleman. I am Sushil Sachena.
Hello?
Yes, hello. In fact, we have taken out two fruit juices. This one is pineapple juice,
mm-hmm.
And this one is apple juice. Why don't you try?
I think I'll try the apple juice.
Sure. Give me a few choices. Okay. Apple juice.
Mm-hmm.
Good, isn't it?
What, isn't it too sweet to be natural?
No, it is meant to be sweet. It is made sweet so that we will like it.
That means you've added a sweetener to it.
Yes, yes, we have added sweetness.
Isn't that bad for the health?
No. Sweeteners are not bad for health. I mean, I've been having too many sweet things. I think I'm healthy.
No, well, I'm not going to comment on your health. And are these approved by the Food and Adulteration Department of India?
Food and?
Adulteration Department.
Yes, it is approved by Food and Adulteration Department and all the departments. We rest assured that it is approved.
Well, I don't feel so assured, but tell me, why shouldn't I have a fresh fruit juice instead of this packed one?
Listen, Ms. Shashi, if you go down to a fresh fruit juice shop, there's so much of dust, there's so much of dirt, and then you have to go all the way, come all the way, or someone has to be sent.
Yeah.
This is, you just take it out of your refrigerator,
but where is the refrigerator in the office? We don't have any refrigerators here.
You have no refrigerator?
No.
Then you just take it out like that.
I think we'll apply to our MD for a refrigerator in all our rooms so that we may store your fresh fruit juices and give them to all our guests.
Good idea.
Yeah.
Good idea.
What else does it contain besides artificial sweeteners?
It contains fresh fruit pulp, sweetener I told you earlier, and it contains preservatives.
But again, they are natural things. So how much does each pack cost?
Cost is if you take it in bulk.
Bulk means how many?
Well, for a company like you, 5,000, 10,000.
No, I don't think they're going to go in for so many. Okay. Let's say suppose a carton or two.
Carton or two? Then it will be with everything, say 5 rupees 50 paisa.
5 rupees 50 paisa. But that is not even viable with the fresh fruit juice cost.
Why not viable?
It's certainly not viable because I can get a glass of fresh fruit juice. A small glass I can get for 3 to 4 rupees. A big glass I can get for 6 to 7 rupees.
No. Listen to me. See, gentlemen guests come to your office, you serve them soft drinks, cold drinks, okay. But when you serve a special fruit juice, that is where you stand out from other companies. You are different.
I see.
And they say, look, you know, it's different.
In keeping with our company. Well, we already have a contract with the cold drink parlor downstairs. He serves us cold, chilled cold drinks whenever we want them. No hassle of applying to MDs for refrigerators. So I don't really think this is a very...
You give them a chance and you will never go for cold drinks, I assure you.
Well, my personal preference is a fruit juice, of course, minus preservatives and minus sweetener. But even this is an okay substitute, so I guess sneakily. So we'll see about it if we can accommodate your fresh fruit juice.
Yeah, that's very nice. And should I take these or should I? No, I'll leave them for you, these two.
Thank you so much. Very gracious of you, if I may say so.
Sorry. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Thanks a lot.
We'll get in touch with you in case we need you.
Sure. And if you don't get in touch with me, we'll again get in touch with you.
Yes.
As their career. That one has the knack of initiating a dialogue with anybody, anywhere, is not the only credential of a sales personnel. One has to be intuitive and imaginative. Above all, one has to develop the skill of being a good listener. Experience teaches all that. Plus, the ability to give direction to a conversation. Lead the conversation towards your goal without diluting the main purpose one bit.
This finished product stores. This is the assembly area. This magnetic gaskets. This foaming.
Yes? May I come in, sir? Oh, come in. Okay, Mr. Jan, excuse me. I'll see you later.
Right.
Come in, please. My name is Mr. Sharma.
Good morning. Mr. Arvind Banerjee?
Right, sir. Please sit down. Thank you very much. Make yourself comfortable. Thank you. You have got a lovely office, sir, I must say.
It's very neat and clean.
You are very neat and clean, and I must say it's exceptional.
Is it?
Very, very good.
That's our endeavor. We try to keep it neat and clean.
Our full office philosophy is based on that.
Oh, that's very nice. But, you know, when I was coming in, one thing struck my eyes. That was, I think we got a lot of files around.
I hope you didn't log into our account section.
Oh, I did, yeah.
You did?
Yeah. You know, can you tell me something like how you operate as far as the dealer network is concerned? Financial aspect.
Oh, the financial
aspect. I mean the credit. You know, like you buy components, raw materials, other things. At what terms and conditions you buy those and how you put it back to the market in the assembled form. And, you know, you got various things. You got clear customs, you got excise and other things, you know. Then you're something about your banking function. But how, in a brief, how this whole function goes about?
Okay, fine. It's a two-way system. With our dealers, we have the credit facility.
Mm-hmm.
And that is again in stages depending on how the sales are. But the products that we buy, those are on cash payment. As a matter of fact, we have to pay advances there.
So that means your whole functioning of the organization involves a lot of accounting work. Now, sir, in this case, have you ever thought of a mechanized system, I mean, something like computer?
Computers,
yeah.
I thought probably computers would involve a lot much more manpower, much more expenditure.
No, sir, I don't think so, because I've been, you know, involved in a lot of computer transactions, and I've been to a lot of companies who have realized that computer...
It seems like this call will never end. The entry was smart, and Arjun did gain the attention of the beholder. But then, what went wrong?
Madam, yeah, is your managing director, Mr. Sharma, is he in town? He is. What time is he in the office generally?
Let your client evince desire for your product or services. Arouse him. Bring in conviction. Talk of opportunity cost. Bring in price only if you have to. Timing is important.
Thank you. Yes, Mr. Chopra, what brings you in here?
Well, Mr. Sharma, I will be really frank with you. I will not tell you a cliche of a sales guy, you know, like I was just passing by and I thought I'll say hello or something of this kind. It's a very calculated visit. In fact, we have been following your company since the last one and a half years, you know, since the time you went berserk in advertising, you know.
Just about,
about a year and a half back.
Yeah, it was like 4 days and one painting,
yes.
Newspapers and
yes.
TV.
And basically to study the TV market, you know, and with specifically your case as a case study. And we found that you have increased your market share phenomenally. I think now you are number 3 or number 4 in the industry.
That's right.
Industry.
You're number 3, right?
Number 3.
Yes.
And at a market share of 10%.
Yes, around that figure.
And I think your number 1 in your industry is 12% and number 2 is number 5?
Yes, we are about 2% below the number 1.
Exactly. And I think you have been at this status for the last 8 months. You have not grown by the same rate as you have been growing earlier.
That's right. We have been trying though.
Now, Mr. Sharma, have you ever analyzed as to why is it so? I mean, why is it that once you were going with leaps and bounds and now suddenly you have stagnated at a, say, a market share of 10%? How?
Yes, we do our research in our own way, really.
I mean, you mean to say your sales managers and your branch managers do their independent surveys?
They do. Mm-hmm. We, as a matter of fact, we have a dealer network system,
yeah,
through which we deal.
Mm-hmm.
And our people...
They take opinion from these people.
Yes, they take opinion from these people. Then we
Mr. Sharma, sorry to interrupt, but I think that in these kind of situations, I mean, since your product is selling today, you know, a normal man would like to be a sycophant, you know. He will give you a feedback which you would like to hear, which will be away from the truth. Don't you agree with me?
Well, in what you say, there is some truth, yes.
And also, you know, managers, I mean, without causing, I mean, I'm not pointing a finger at anybody of any one of them. What I'm trying to say is that at times it such, it so happens that one is not able to comprehend the entire situation in totality.
What I'm coming to is, Mr. Sharma, examine a situation when you project a market size as, say, X.
And when you were, so nowhere, I mean, when you were just entering the trade, that time it did not matter whether X was 6,000, 7,000, or how far was it away from the truth. But supposing today you were X,
yes,
is not the market size, it is 10% less than the market size. Say the actual market size is 10% plus X. That means you're not going to be able to realize that you're not catering to the total market. Is it not that segment of 10% which is not making you grow up to 12%?
In short, what you're suggesting is that to achieve this 10%,
the effort required is much more.
Effort required, I'm
looking. You said that, I mean, we are assuming that you're not aware of that 10% market. You said you're not getting any authentic market size figure from anybody.
Okay, go ahead, let's see what you're coming to.
What I'm trying to say is that supposing you hire our services, and we carry out surveys in various markets and give you the total market size. And once you are able to get the total market size, I think you will be able to target your market, your product better at the market, and you will be able to achieve your ambition, which is to be number one. I'm sure you want to be number one. Everybody wants to be number one.
And yeah, I follow your point. Sir, are you suggesting some ways for it?
Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm coming to. I'm coming to say my services, our services, we are a premium market research body in India, and we've been carrying out a lot of surveys. And we thought we would, carry out the study for you. We will give you market sizes, market shares, and...
Sorry, what other organizations have you done such studies for? And for what products?
We've done it for a lot of trade associations. I mean, we've done it for the automobile association, we've done it for the soap industry, we're also doing something for the rural banking industry. And, I mean, these kind of...
Not so far for a product like ours.
No, we have done it for renewables. We have done it for refrigerators.
Yes.
We have not done it for TVs, but we would have to do it for TVs.
I think for a moment, yes, we could perhaps consider that angle. Could you elaborate on that?
So we'll give you a brand-wise percentage.
You'll be suggesting some sort of forecast.
No, we will not do that, yes. Mr. Sharma, I will not oversell myself by saying that I will give you via media and news. What I will do is I will basically give you figures. Like, okay, this is the market size, this is your market share. That's all. I mean, it's up to you, because you will agree that I might suggest a few things, but you might not be in a position to do that. Like, supposing I say you put in X amount of money in a particular market.
Okay.
But you don't have the resources.
Okay, and Mr. Chopra, suppose we do consider giving you this sort of a workout. Mm-hmm. How do you suggest we go about it?
Well, Mr. Sharma, what I will suggest is initially, I think you should give me a test survey. I mean, give me a small area where you're planning to enter, so that you can also, I can also build my credibility here.
So I'll give you a particular sector. I would like you to conduct your market research there.
Yeah.
And
why don't you put me on to the financial manager so that I can talk about finance also? I think I wouldn't like to disturb you on this. Now it is okay with you. I mean, it's okay with you. I'll talk to your finance manager for the monetary aspects of this deal.
Well, then, for validation, we compare it with the results.
Sure.
Let's see what the outcomes are.
Yeah.
And
I'm sure if we are able to give you good outcomes, I think you will give us further business. I mean, that's the basic thing.
Certainly, but let this be a test case.
Okay. Thank you.
Every call, whether it closes or not, teaches a lesson or two. Carry out content analysis after every call.